Exercise 10, legal dictation. Get ready, start. While appreciating the evidence of a witness, the approach must be whether the evidence of the witness read as a whole appears to be truthful in the given circumstances of the case. Once that impression is formed, it is necessary for the court to scrutinize the evidence more particularly, keeping in view the drawbacks and infirmities pointed out in the evidence and evaluate them to find out whether it is against the general tenure of the prosecution case. Jeevan Lal, PW1, is the son of the deceased Meena Devi, residing with her and the accused in the same house and a natural witness to speak about the occurrence. Evidence of PW1 is cogent and natural and is consistent with the prosecution case. The High Court was not right in doubting the evidence of PW1 on the ground of alleged improvements made by Jeevan Lal and rejecting his evidence on the premise that there was certain improvements as pointed out by the sessions judge. Deceased Meena Devi was last seen alive in the company of accused Rajkumar, and the accused did not satisfactorily explain the missing of deceased Meena Devi, and the same is a strong militating circumstances against the accused Meena Devi, who was residing in the same house with the accused and was last seen alive with the accused. It is for him to explain how the deceased died. The accused has no reasonable explanation as to how the body of Meena Devi was found hanging from the tree as held in Kasi Ram's case. It is for the accused to explain as to what happened to the deceased. If the accused does not throw light on the fact which is within his knowledge, his failure to offer any explanation would be a strong militating circumstance against him, as pointed out earlier in his questioning under Section 313 CRPC. The accused simply denied the evidence of incriminating circumstance put to him and pleaded that he is innocent. A feeble attempt was made by the defense to suggest that the deceased accused consumed poison and committed suicide. Viscera of deceased Meena Devi was sent, and as per FSL report, no poison was detected in the viscera of the deceased. In our considered view, the trial court rightly rejected the plea suggested by the defense, as pointed out earlier in a catena of judgments. This court held that when conviction is based on circumstantial evidence, there should not be any gap in the chain of circumstances. The accused is entitled to the benefit of doubt. The circumstances relied upon by the prosecution are proved by cogent and reliable evidence. The circumstances cumulatively taken from a complete chain pointing out that the murder was committed by the accused and none else. In the appeal, the High Court has not properly appreciated the evidence and intrinsic worth of testimony of prosecution witnesses and the formidable circumstances established by the prosecution against the accused. The High Court entailed fanciful doubts and rejected the credible evidence of Jeevan Lal on slender grounds. Stop.